Hello and welcome to another episode of Media Research. I am Ramesh Menon. I have been a journalist for the last 34 years and have enjoyed working with print, television and the new media. Down the years, I have learned to value media research as it gives tremendous insight into the work that we do as journalists. In an earlier episode of Media Research, we had touched upon a host of concepts. We had spoken of the importance of media research, how it helps plan out modern day strategies, different types of media research, techniques used, and so on. Today, we'll look at some new areas like the researcher can conduct personal interviews. Thanks to email, the questionnaires can now be shot off to numerous people in distant places. But most of the time, mail is ignored. That is why personal interviews are more useful as responses can be observed and recorded.
There is something called precision journalism. Philip Mayers has started this precision journalism. What says journalists should use the social science research methods in journalism. That means journalists is no more just information provider, but journalists have become analytics. They are analyzing so many events, social events, and for deeper and broader analysis, they need to apply proper social method research for it.
The key here is relevance. Structured interviews where questions are selected, framed and organized properly are the best. Another option is unstructured interviews where there are no preset questions. It offers flexibility. It's easy for extended explorations and follow-ups. Starts with general questions and goes to a specific one. Here is one example. A general question could be, what do you think of India's economic policy? A specific question could be, what do you think of value-added tax in Delhi? It begins with specific questions. It ends with general questions. An example of this would be, what do you think of the television boom in India? A question which is previously asked is asked again in a different way to counter-check or even to get additional information. Be smart to frame the question differently. These are asked to get to the depth of the subject and get more explanations. The Gallup organization, which runs the famous Gallup polls, devised the following principles for conducting interviews. Questions should be short and to the point. The words and phrases should be simple. The question should avoid bias in a point of view. The question must include all important alternatives. Research can be of three types: basic research, applied research, and action research. It adds organized knowledge to the existing body of knowledge. It does not produce results of immediate value. It is also called fundamental or pure research. It aims at improving a product or process. It is testing of theoretical concepts in specific problem situations. The concern here is with the solution of immediate problems. Action research aims at improving social reality. Its finding can be carried into effect by the administrator and the layman. It is not much concerned with the development of theory, but would want the layman creatively participating. While pure research is done by outside specialists, action research is done by those who are taken to evaluate their own work situation. Research has the following characteristics. Research is objective and verifiable. Research calls for vigorous and valid data gathering procedures and diligent observation. Research aims at solutions to problems. Procedures for research have to be carefully chosen. Research calls for patience. Good research must be purposive. Objectivity is the chief trait of all good research. Good research should adopt interdisciplinary approach to the study of man and society. Good research strikes a balance between quantitative and qualitative facts. Good research must contribute to the widening of knowledge, providing solutions to society. As science and technology advance, research is imperative and will grow in importance. Research contributes to new facts, insight, and foresight. Research helps to dispel myths and antiquated practices. Research requires mastery in seeing things with vision, handling equipment, knowledge of research methods, treating data statistically, analyzing and interpreting results, and writing reports. Research equips us to find solutions to vexed problems. Development of knowledge is not possible without research. It contributes to innovative ideas. Those who are into research do not have a boring moment. Researchers are always looking for answers and never can be sure where they'll find them or what they will find. It is the job of a researcher to discover or uncover something that is usually unnoticed. Researchers often find their sources lying, sometimes offering conflicting stories and sometimes behaving in baffling ways. That is why researchers spend many hours doing what they do. Many students do not have the opportunity to conduct research. At the most, they do a term paper which ends up as a library research project where they get relevant experts and authorities stringing quotations together. These projects are based on the research of others and are one step removed from the actual research process. Doing a term paper is a useful exercise and a standard mode of operation, but it does not give students an understanding of what real research is like or an appreciation of the fascination this research generates. One of the main reasons why media research is so difficult and challenging is that people are so complicated and hard to figure out. If you go around surveying people with a questionnaire, any of the following might take place. People will tell you what they feel you want to hear. People will lie and not tell you what they really think. People may tend to deal with the questionnaire as a joke. People will tell you what they actually think, but they may not have any information. The information they give you may not be useful. People will give you their opinions that are based on the information they have, which might be mediocre. Surveys and questionnaires are two of the most common ways of finding out what people think about things. Their beliefs, their opinions, actions that they have taken, actions that they are contemplating and so on.
Journalists are supposed to do proper survey. They can do content analysis and so many other methods of media research they can apply in their work. And if you have the perception, concept of media research clear in your mind, you will understand the consequences, the reason behind it. Your analysis, even for a journalism story, for a covering a story, will be much more deeper and more thorough. So it is going to help you to become a better journalist altogether.
Conducting surveys is a relatively inexpensive way of obtaining information. You can ask a considerable number of questions. However, you must be careful that you do not ask so many questions that your respondents become irritated. If your sampling is correct, surveys and other forms of opinion polls are generally reasonably accurate. Of late, television networks have started employing pollsters who have developed sophisticated ways of sampling people as they leave voting booths. As a result of information obtained from these people, election results can often be predicted with some degree of accuracy even before the results are announced. People answering surveys may not give honest answers. This is particularly true when controversial issues are discussed. In answering survey questions, people often exaggerate their incomes, have mistaken notions of what social class they belong to, lie about their ages, and claim things they never do. When you have finished your interviewing, figure out the best way to interpret your findings. Can you create a chart that will show you what you have found? Whatever be the case, you should assemble your data in a logical way and then try to figure out what your data means. What does it say about the group that you studied? Searching the library for information on a particular subject can be very much like looking for a needle in a haystack, especially if you do not know how to conduct your search. Libraries have thousands of books, but you should know where to look and where to find the information that you want. Library search databases can help by refining your search. Try and get data which is the latest. Focus groups are group interviews to find out how some people feel about some product, service, or issue. A group of people are assembled and a free discussion is held. It is held by a moderator to obtain the desired information. The aim of the discussion is not to build consensus, but to find out what each member of the focus group thinks. This also helps to elicit different opinions. Focus groups are basically to probe how people think and act. To begin with, it is difficult to find a representative group of people together to form the focus group. If you want to find out about how people respond to a new product that is being developed to compete with an established product, you must find people who use the product, or you have to find people who could be persuaded to use the product. It is not easy for the moderator to lead the discussion all the time. It takes a light touch and a great deal of skill to get everyone to contribute. Focus groups are a relatively inexpensive way to do research. Focus groups can be assembled quickly. The insights of the focus groups are immediately available. Focus groups can be easily audio taped and videotaped. Then the video can be replayed for analysis based on body language. Focus groups also provide a great degree of flexibility to the interviewer. The moderator can easily follow up on some response a member of the group makes, can ask questions, solicit opinions, raise issues, and so on. Group dynamics ensures that respondents get involved and contribute fruitfully to the discussion. There is a problem with the generalization of results because of the very nature of focus groups. A focus group represents a relatively small group of people, and they may not be representative of the potential users of a product or service. That is why it is important to assemble focus groups carefully. Some participants in the focus group tend to monopolize the conversation and must be restrained without inhibiting other members of the group. Some participants would be shy and will have to be drawn out without being made uncomfortable. To begin with, the moderator must explain the purpose of the focus group, how it works, what their function is, and so on. Must make members feel that they are at ease. Tell them that all opinions are valuable. Get any demographic information that might be interesting. Does not direct the discussion. Focus groups are non-directive. If someone says something that has important implications, get that person to speak more, then get others to comment. Get everyone involved in the discussion. Stick to the subject. Repeat what you understand them to have said as a means of clarifying things and stimulating others to contribute ideas and views. When you write what you have discovered in the research projects, remember your main goal is to convey information in the simplest way possible. There is a common feeling that research projects are dull and boring. It need not be so. Bring life into your writing with descriptions, examples, anecdotes, statistics, parameters, and an easy style. Take great care of your grammar. Grammatical errors show that writing is substandard and does not follow the rules and conventions. Many of us ignore pronunciations. If you do that, you do it at your own peril. A comma in the wrong place can change the meaning of what you are saying. Avoid padding. Students often pad their research work as they have little to say. They often use 25 words when just 5 would do. Watch out for incoherent writing. This refers to writing that does not flow, that jumps around and leaves the reader or listener confused. One way to write coherently is to use transitions which guide the reader. Transitions tell us what to expect. Unclear writing is hard to understand. It's confusing and ambiguous. Do not repeat the same idea in different words. Avoid cliches. Stacking the deck involves the use of selected instances so that it supports your conclusion while you choose to ignore those instances that contradict it. When you use selected instances, you may be telling the truth, but you also may not be telling the whole truth. By avoiding certain material, you end up with a distorted and incorrect picture of whatever you are describing. When you use emotionally toned words, you are in a way trying to avoid logic. If you can get people excited, they'll not exercise much discretion and won't be too concerned whether you are telling the truth or not. Do not we see this technique used every day in advertising? We even see it daily in news television. Write a brief introduction detailing out what information you wanted to find. Why you wanted this information? What you found? Attach a copy of your survey so readers can evaluate it in terms of its fairness and comprehensiveness. Present your data in some easy-to-read format, giving the questions and findings of your survey. Connect your findings with social characteristics of the people that you studied. Analyze the results. Always qualify your answers and avoid any sweeping generalizations. Deal with the difficulties you faced in making the survey and explain what you did to overcome them or compensate for them. Write an introduction to give your reader an idea of the general background of the subject, an overview, and a sense of context. Tell the reader what your research questions were and what your conclusions are. You should explain how you went about getting information, what you found, and how you arrived at your conclusion. Provide the reader with data and other reasons to accept your conclusions. If you have to qualify your conclusions, explain what they were and how you dealt with them. Provide some kind of wrap-up at the end of your paper so that your reader is not left hanging. Summarize what you found so that the reader can get a quick idea of what you have done. Reports give researchers an opportunity to present their findings and to discuss the results of their research. The purpose of the research report is to offer a clear and ambiguous statement of what was done, how it was done, and what was found. This is a standard format for research papers. This includes an introduction and sections on methods, findings, and discussion. The introduction lays out the problem or the subject being studied. The introduction should provide the reader with an overview of the research project. In this section, you can discuss methods used in the study, describing them in some detail and explaining why you used them. The choice of the method is crucial because each methodology has certain strong points and deficiencies. Here you can present and analyze data. You can use tables and graphics to make your point. Here you can draw conclusions based on your findings. Be as truthful as possible. Researchers have a moral obligation to be as honest as possible and to present their findings as accurately as they can. They must also respect the privacy and dignity of any informants used in the research projects. Here you can quickly summarize the findings of your report, the analysis, and the conclusion. Research reports should be written in a general, neutral manner. Avoid jargon as far as possible. When you use a technical term, define it so that your reader is clear about how you are using it. In some cases, of course, when you are dealing with highly technical matters, it is impossible to write in plain English. There is a simple way to avoid being accused of plagiarism. If you use stuff written by others, please remember to give credit to the authors. If you are quoting someone, please put quote marks around the quote and seamlessly try to integrate it into the material. Also, please identify the person quoted so that the reader knows where it comes from and why it sounds the way it does. You should end your research paper with some kind of concluding statement. One way is to write a brief summary in which you recapitulate your findings and discuss its significance. It's a way of wrapping things up and reminding your reader of what you have done and what you have found. Another way is to summarize what you have done and use your findings to arrive at some new insight. It could be a generalization, an idea, or a theory that stems from your research that may have implications for further research. In some cases, you may be able to return to an argument that you have made in the beginning. Or you may find some witty remark or use clever wordplay that is appropriate. Whatever be the case, you must find a way of ending your research paper in such a way that the reader would be satisfied and not left hanging. Your research paper must come to a conclusion and not just stop as you have reached your word limit or that you are too lazy to work hard on a conclusion.
While you are learning, being a student, the media research, do not only read and concentrate on the theoretical perspective. You know survey. What is survey? You can write. But unless you do a survey, unless you know how to conduct a survey, your knowledge will not be complete. So whatever you are learning, apply it. Do content analysis. While you are doing it, you will face many difficulties. And when you know how to solve the difficulties, that becomes the practical knowledge. So you need to have this practical and application based attitude to know the media research. While ever you are studying media research, be more practical and apply whatever you are learning to know it completely.
We have now seen how media research plays such a crucial role. Let us now summarize what we did today. We covered a large area today and hope it has made sense to you. Research has an excitement of its own and you will not understand its value till you experience it. So go ahead and start researching on something today. Try and use all the tips and suggestions that we have discussed today and you will have a research report that you will be proud of. That's all we have for today. Goodbye and take care.